y'all. Well, I see Rhino here. I hope you had a chance to check out my reaction video to RuPaul's Drag Race Season 10, Episode 3. I'm going to go ahead and, as my good Judy Alyssa Edwards might say, I'm going to get into this untucked gig. I'm lying. I don't know Elizabeth. Great. So let's go ahead and get started.
I'm safe, but I feel like I might be thrown under the bus. I just don't trust it.
Well, you're safe, so it don't matter. Shit. I wouldn't worry about it.
Oh my. Girl, cocktail.
It is about time.
I am bitch. Not liking that look. I do not like that look that she is serving. It just does not. They look so good in this light. I wish they looked like this on the main stage. I don't think her look was the only problem though. Her acting was terrible.
She just drew on a nice face. I just put dots all over. That's why I did not want to be a group leader. Because being a group leader here, you feel like you need to take on the weight of your whole team, and you can't. And because if your team goes down and they happen to judge us as a group, you're going down first.
We tried to make sure that my team, everybody's opinion was heard, said, everyone's contributions, like we all brought something to the table, because Mayhem was supposed to be the narrator. Then Cameron, she's like, let's switch with Mayhem.
Since I wrote out the opening lines, do you want me to narrate? Since I know them really well, since I wrote them, that's fine with me.
Stunning. Okay.
All right.
Once that happened, you
co-signed on it.
Completely in her head, and I'm like, girl, it still felt like your voice was hers.
To be fair, she's voiced to me that she feels like she sometimes gets like hounded over with everyone with their big personalities.
Yeah, that is bullshit.
She has a big personality. I feel like she picks and chooses when she wants to let it out. I just hope them bitches, when I watch this, they better not throw me under the bus, because they will be getting a ungodly phone call. And then I'm going to put the bitch on YouTube. I want them to come back.
God, everybody's makeup looks so good in the untucker.
When you're up standing before the judges, it's easier to throw someone else under the bus
than
to call out your own faults.
That ain't gonna help them.
Let's talk about this elephant in the room.
What, girl?
I would really like if y'all hoes learn how to play well and work with each other.
Amen.
And y'all hoes specifically.
Oh my God. Amen. Because I am sick of the damn bickering. Oh my God, stop!
Negative.
The bickering is too much.
And got spanked.
Doesn't matter how much I like you, if you set yourself up, I'ma hit you. So honestly, what I responded to was you saying that I didn't bring my best drag.
But I understand.
And then what the problem is,
but y'all fight every week.
You brought that to me, and with me responding, you already know who I am. When you come for me and I come for you back and you say, oh,
I know, but you need to just learn to ignore that shit sometime, Vixen.
You
ain't got to respond
friend.
To everything.
You've been and standoffish to me.
Really?
Absolutely.
Damn, Aquaria. She's feeling so attacked right now, y'all.
You know I'm tough. Y'all know I go there. So if you bring it over here, you should have already been prepared that it was coming back.
Okay, but what about the rest of us that have to be subjected to it?
Your best drive.
That's the problem.
Your best drive?
For one for all. I may not always get your sense of humor, but I want to let you know that I love you. And you said, my jokes don't always land well. Thank you, and I love you too.
I just have to say, Aquaria, rewind.
Damn.
Back.
They are all going in on Aquaria right now.
I can call you a friend.
Which is a negative comment. I don't hear Eureka talking trash on me.
It's a part of our culture to be able to throw shade and
there was just a difference between shade and a snide comment.
Yeah.
But what is the difference from Vixen making a snide comment and you making
exactly.
That's something I...
Don't dish it out if you can't take it. I think Aquaria needs a little reality check.
But here we go. But in the workroom.
No, 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 no. So it's not right. I gotta say this. So this right here is exactly what it is. You say something, I say something, you start crying. You have created a narrative of I am an angry black woman who is scared off the little white
person. I understand that
even
narrative.
Doesn't matter how you do it. And so when you get super defensive,
oh,
tell me
God,
that
Dusty,
when I'm just responding to what
Cracker
you want to me,
very uncomfortable.
That will always read to these as a race issue.
I don't know how she got there with this, but
Vixen actually has a very good point.
I'm very nervous to even bring it up, but
so what I'm saying is,
God,
leave me alone.
Yeah, that's basically, that would be the best.
Wasn't there like,
you're always on the defense, so you're just like, bitch, I'm a 10, and I'm always at a 10, and I'm ready to attack. But see, I feel like that is going to hinder what is your blessing.
Okay, if I could make a request, if you could come in, come back at people at a 5 instead of a 10. Wait.
No. You just said, can you?
No, I can't. If you come at me,
you're going to have a hard time in this life, girl.
Like, don't make me throw shit.
All right. Go ahead.
Honestly, I respect someone that she's like, I'm not down in the back. Oftentimes, I fold and I change, but you are, you're like, this is me. This is what it is. And I appreciate that.
Yeah, but that's not going to win you any damn friends. Long term, that can't, you can't be like that.
Thank you, ladies.
How was your critique?
They said I was flat in the video. They didn't really understood my runway as well. I think I'm definitely in the bottom two.
Ma'am, what did they say to you?
You're definitely in the bottom going home.
They said from...
You two were in the same group, right?
Yeah.
Wasn't there like a few people thrown under the bus?
Damn, Eureka.
I wouldn't say thrown under the bus.
We wasn't going to say that. Then you didn't brought it up.
You were our team leader and I followed your direction. You're really quiet, and we heard, like, oh, you's probably going to be, like, well, a certain way, and I was like, no, like, I didn't want to be that girl in the group and say, I don't like this, and this, and that, and I want this, and that, I followed your lead.
It's not RuPaul's best friend race.
But I think, honestly, Money, I will mention, you do have a very strong and
very,
assertive
very
personality.
But I'm very, but I'm,
she
I'm
gave
sorry.
Her.
I didn't get a word in edgewise right now. I can only imagine being in your group.
Sorry.
Go ahead. I mean, that's all I'm saying.
Is she using one of them damn sponges?
I can see them possibly holding their tongue so that they, you know what I mean?
I got to rewind it. Is she using that fucking
personality? But I'm sorry.
I can't even get a word in edgewise right now. I can only imagine being in your group. Sorry.
Yes, she is.
I can see a couple. I can see them possibly.
I'm here to, like, do my thing. I'm not here to play dirty.
All right, y'all. We're talking shit in the corner.
I'm sorry. I took my head out of the game.
You put your head back in the game, girl.
I should have stepped up.
Shit.
And said something.
But even though I'm in the bottom two, I'm not going to let this defeat me. I gotta focus on me. And prove to Rue and the judges that I want to stay here and that it is not over yet for me.
I got some bad news for you.
Being a team player got my ass sent to the bottom, and I don't like that.
No, you can be a team player.
To prove that
you
I
just still need
America's
to speak up for yourself. I mean, shit.
And I need to wake up.
Has she watched this show before?
The way that I know I can.
You know what happens when people
to
don't
it,
say
and
nothing?
To believe it,
they ask, go home.
Do it.
You are Hamasaki. You're part of the family. And I'm going to miss you. Now, sashay away.
Bye.
I did not think I was going to be going home this early. I thought I was going to be
God, they didn't give her a whole lot of... They didn't give her a lot of screen time.
It's a tough group of girls. We're all very talented.
I love that she comes back into the workroom with the bra. She took her makeup off but left the bra.
You are. I love you. I'm so happy that... Does New York City sisters got to experience this together? Love you. Bye. The conversation got into my head a little bit because I was so comfortable. I was doing so well in week one and week two that I got complacent.
Can't ever do that.
This competition f*** with your emotions. So much. Like, I thought I knew myself, like, but I found out more stuff about myself. Like, it was very therapeutic, I find it.
Don't get your ass kicked by your own suitcase. Goodbye, Yua. We'll be seeing ya.
It is not the end yet. You'll be seeing a lot of silly me, funny me, stupid me everywhere. Mwah. See you soon.
Bye, girl. Bye. Okay, that was it. Very good, Untucked. I am so glad they finally addressed the Vixen and Aquarius situation, because I don't know how many more weeks I could deal with that back and forth. I'm sure it's not over. I'm sure they'll get into it again. And chances are they don't get along because they're so much alike. And by the end of it, they'll be crying over each other. Or they may do like they've done. I'm trying to remember what season. Was it the season when... Was it when Alyssa and Coco Montrese had to go against each other? It's like, I'm sure they'll work it so that the two of them will have to lip sync against each other before all said and done. And they can go ahead and end this rivalry once and for all. But, you know, good episode of Untucked. I really enjoyed it. I hope Mayhem kind of took tonight's scare, or I guess technically it was last night's scare. She took it to heart, and she's not going to, dim her own light to be part of a team. She's got to remember, this is an individual sport. Only one person's going to win, and she's got to give it her all every single time. So, I hope you enjoyed my reaction, and I will see you guys later. Good night.